Hello friends, this is another very interesting and important question for placement preparation for different service based companies. Okay, and the problem title is sliding window maximum. I have taken this particular problem from LeetCode. Okay, so what is the problem? First, let us try to understand. The question says, given an array nums, there is a sliding window of size k which is moving from the very left of the array to the very right. You can only see k numbers in the window. Each time the sliding window moves right by one position, and the return, you have to return the maximum sliding window, max, that is maximum element of that particular sliding window. Okay, so what is that? Let us try to understand with this particular example. Suppose our input is a nums array, which is basically 1 3 -1 -3 5 3 6 7, and k, that is window size, is equal to 3. These two we are passing through our function, which we have to write, and the output of the function should be one array which is like this, 3 3 5 5 6 7. Now how we are getting the output? The explanation is clearly written here. Consider this particular array itself, that is 1 3 -1 -3 5 3 6 7. That's what here it is written, 1 3 -1 -3 5 3 6 7. Now, as my window size is 3, so that we will take first 3 elements from the left side, and among 1, 3, minus 1, the maximum element is 3, so our function should return 3. Then, after that, as it is mentioned that each time the sliding window moves right by one position, what will happen? The window will be slided to the right hand side by one position, and my new window elements will be 3, minus 1, minus 3. Among these, 3 is the maximum, so 3 will be printed. Next, again, when window will be slided in the right hand side by one position, the new elements of the window will be 1 -3 5, and among 1 -3 5 5 is the maximum, so output should be 5. Like that, if it goes on, we will get this particular array as output, which is basically storing the maximum element in that particular sliding window, that is 3 3 5 5 6 7. All right. Now, how we can solve this kind of problem? You can pause this video and try to think one solution which can be used to solve this particular problem. But one condition it is given: could you solve it in linear time? That is, the solution which you are thinking or trying to perform for computing this particular problem must have O of n time complexity. Okay, please pause the video and try to think. Here I am discussing the solution. So what we are going to do? We are going to use sliding window concept in this particular case. So basically, what we will do, we will create one array list, and we will store all the elements of the first window in that array list, and we will simply compute our maximum element among those. Okay, that is 3, we will simply print. And from the next iteration onwards, we no need to store all the elements. What we will do, see, just consider this first window, 1, 3, minus 1 is there. In this second window, 3, minus 1, minus 3 is there. So what we can do? Simple. From the previous window, that is 1, 3, minus 1, we can remove this first element, that is 1, we will remove. And the next element, that is minus 3, we will add, and we can get this particular next window position after sliding, that is 3 minus 1 minus 3. Again, if you consider next iteration case, 3 as the first element, we will remove that, and next element 5 we will add, so we will get the next window position, that is minus 1 minus 3 5. All right, like this we can slide, and each time as we are storing our window in an array list, so we can use Java collection function, that is collection dot max of that particular array list name. If you write, you will get simply the maximum of the particular array list, right? No need to do bubble sort or some other sorting techniques. All right, so basically like that we can solve this particular problem in O of n time complexity. Here I have written the code, very simple. Class solution, okay, our class name is solution. You can give class name according to your choice. Public int array, okay, so return type might be one array. Max sliding window, this is our function name. Int array a, int k. So we are passing the array, that is here it is, which is stored in the variable nums, and k, that is window size. Okay, the window has which has to be slided, what is the size of that? That a second argument we are passing through our function. Now if a dot length not equal to 0, okay, this condition I will explain later. For the time being, just consider this one. So what we are doing, we are creating two array list integer c equal to new array list and array list integer d equal to new array list. Okay, in Java collection, if you don't know the size of the particular array which is going to be, we can use two list concept. One is array list, another one is linked list. But always try to work with array list, because in linked list, it will take more time to iterate or to go to the next element like that. Because in linked list, next element is directly not present. We have the next reference address of that particular node. We will go there and then only we can extract. But in array list, internally array is implemented. So basically, all the elements are placed in a memory serially, okay, or consecutively, so that it is easy to iterate, okay. So int l equal to a dot length, we are calculating the array length which we are passing through this function. Now I told you that first, the first window we have to store in the array list, that is 1, 3, -1, and from next onwards we will remove the first element, we will add the next element like that. So this particular for loop is used to store all the elements of the first window size in the c array list. So c is here our sliding window, okay. So for int j equal to 0, j less than k, j++, c dot add a of j. All right. Now I told you to calculate the maximum, we can use this particular function, that is collections dot max. Like for these are basically very, very interesting and important tools to compute easily in a competitive programming. You should memorize this, okay? Like collections dot max, then collections dot sort, okay? That is also very, very important, okay? If you want to sort one collection, no need to implement anything, bubble sort, selection sort like that. You can simply write collections dot sort and your array list or linked list will be sorted, okay? So d dot add collections dot max c. So d, what it is doing, d is basically used to store all the maximum elements, that is here, you, if you consider this for example 3, 3, 5, 5, 6, 7, these maximum elements of the particular slide window, it is used to store okay. So d is storing that maximum. So d dot add collections dot max c. Now what I told you, from the next window slided position, we need to remove the first element, we need to add the next element. So what I am doing, for int j equal to k, j less than l, j++, why j equal to k? See, here you consider my window size is 3, so 0 to 2 element already it is stored in that particular window. Now our loop will start from here. This is what, index position 3, right? Because 0, 1, 2 and 3 in array list or linked list or array, in case of Java, the index starts from 0, right? 0 index programming language it is called, okay? 1 index programming language is MATLAB, because in MATLAB array index starts from 1, all right? So basically we will start our, from the next iteration for sliding purpose, we will start our loop from what? K, that is window sliding position, like here k equal to 3, so we are starting from here, right? So for int j equal to k, j less than l, l is our length of the array which we have passed through this function, okay? So we have to iterate up to the right hand side, j++, c dot add a of j. We are adding this minus 3 in this window, but we have to simultaneously remove the first element, so c dot remove 0, okay? We are removing the first element. It is kind of queue data structure. First input was this one, so it is removing first. Okay, you can interpret like that also. Now again, for this also we have to compute the maximum in that particular window, that is d dot add collections dot max c. All right, so after execution of this particular part in the d array list, our all the maximum element in that particular window position will be stored. But our return type is what? Return type is c int array, okay? So we have to return one array. So what we can do, our array list is d, we have to convert into array. So we can simply do like this, int dc equal to new in d dot size, we are defining one empty array of size of our array list d, which has stored all the maximum elements. Then for int I equal to 0, I less than d dot size I++, dc I equal to D dot get of I. So we are mapping, basically we are mapping each and every element from D to DC at the same index and return DC. All right, we are returning that array. But there is one condition. Suppose our array is one empty array, and suppose k is 1, okay, because here it is mentioned, you may assume k is always a valid, that is 1 less than equal to k less than equal to input array size of for non-empty array. But if the array is empty array, then there will be no such maximum element. So if the array length is not equal to 0, then only we are going to do that. Otherwise, what we will do, we will return one empty array, okay. So else int d equal to new int 0, okay, 0 means zero length, okay, that is empty array, return d, okay. So you cannot do like this int new int 1 and then return d, because if you do like that, array of length 1 will be created and by default it will be stored zero value, right? But we have to empty array, so we are giving the array length itself as 0, okay. So you can submit that. I hope you have understood the algorithm, because algorithm is important. If you are able to understand the algorithm, you can implement the same program in your favorite language, whether that may be Java or C++ or C or Python or Ruby or Perl. Here lots of options are there. You can implement. I am going to post the same code in the comment section of this video. If you want, you can check there. Thank you for watching.